Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to episode number 13 of the FIFA 22 Ultimate Team Road to Glory. Now, welcome to the era of change, I guess you could call it, in the Road to Glory. Spoiler alert, the next few videos we're going to be changing up the team a lot. Like, I'm pretty sure only one player from the team right now actually remains. So we're going to start by selling the entirety of the left-hand side, not with Lukaku, but with Tony instead. And we're gonna go out and buy a whole new left-hand side, and I'm thinking that's gonna be from the Serie A. So yeah, welcome along to episode number 13 of the Road to Glory. This is the second video of the day, and I think it's actually only gonna be the third. I think there's gonna be four videos today, so yeah, get ready for a few more videos. So as I said in the last one, I'm going away on Tuesday, so I just want to get all the videos up to date, you know. So yeah, this clip is just me going through and selling everybody from the team on the left hand side. The Prem side, that can stay for now. And that's the key part for now. So Tony, we're gonna sell him as well. He was quite good for us, but I did just realize how slow he actually feels in game. Like, he's a very good poacher. He's in the right place at the right time, but you need quicker strikers running off. Like, when you've got Lukaku, who's not the quickest, and Tony, you just need a quicker striker in it. So we're gonna go out and buy them. So that's the team we're gonna try and build. Kessié I already had in the club, untradeable from gold upgrades, which I was doing on the web app. I need to show you some of them. They'll probably be the videos for the next week or so, actually. Anyways, the first player we're going to go out and buy is Nicholas Pope. As was Trent yesterday, no one was below that price. We go out and buy Insigne for 19k. He's back, and he has a hunter on him already. Mertens, we're going to get him back as well for 3.5k, which is an absolute steal with a striker on him already. We're also going to go out and buy Spinazzola for 14,000 coins and Fikayo Tomori for 6k here, which is a very nice snipe. So we could have a triangle with English players at centre back. We're going to go out and buy Joseph Gomez as well in a little while. Hold on, I need to edit this clip out. I'll give you a sec. Alright, I just went through. Turns out I just didn't record when I actually got Joe Gomez. Like, I got him, but I didn't record. I don't know why. Must have edited it wrong. I can't be bothered to go back. But we got Joe Gomez, I think, for 44,000 coins. With a chem style. And I don't even know what chem style that is. But yeah, that's the completed team. Don't get too attached to it, because I think I play with this team one or two times. So just going through the prices there, just look in the top right for bought now. Kessié and Lukaku are both first. Alright, welcome back. Live recording for the first time in what will probably be a week for you guys. But we've got our Division Rivals rewards, and we did Marquee Matchups this morning. Now, there is something going up with it. Why does it? Yeah, rank 3, Div 7 was what we got in the end. But there's some weird thing going on with the ones to watch guaranteed pack, which was supposed to come out today. I'll show you quickly. So, ones to watch player pack pre-order must be opened on or after October the 1st, which is today at 5 o'clock UTC. I think that means I can't open it for a couple of hours, but why would they just release a pack that you literally can't open? Oh, I went into squad bells. But why would they release a pack that you can't open? To be honest, I'm just tempted to see what it is, because I've been going through TikTok and that, and they're just saying, oh yeah, don't open it. What's actually in it? I haven't actually seen anyone open it. But what's in it? I don't know. So yeah, marquee matchups. We got it done. We only had to spend not too much on this one here, which was Saint Etienne versus Olympique Lyonnais. We didn't have to spend a single penny. All of it is first owner. That Decore and this Kemen geezer, I bought them for SBCs before, like hybrid nations, hybrid leagues, whatever, and I didn't actually need them. So, yep, that's the first one done. giving us a premium silver pack. I'll be back once I've claimed all this stuff. I'll actually show you what I got in the packs first, though. Did I say what I got in the packs? I was just going to show you who I was submitting. So, this team, we only had to really go out and buy the left mid, left back, and right back. It was another one of those ones. I think in the Serie A one last week as well, there was like a maximum club cap on it or something, but we got that one done. Next one was Atletico Madrid versus Barcelona. We didn't have to spend a penny on this one. It was just like a Spanish team. That David Lopez and that Ivan Rodriguez. I think I bought them for previous SBCs, but didn't need them. I need to use concept players more, man. But for that one, we get a small rare mixed players pack. And the final one is Liverpool versus Manchester City. As a Manchester City fan, I'm hyped for this game, man. Obviously, we beat Chelsea. We lost to PSG, but it's PSG, man. Like, their team is silly, but we got a Prime Election players pack. We lost to PSG, but I think we're joint second in the league at the minute. So if we could beat Liverpool, who I'm pretty sure are top by like 1 point, and the only team unbeaten, that would obviously be very cool. So we've got 7 packs here to open. The 8th one is the one Swatch pack. We're not going to open that because I've been warned not to open it. I'm not going to open the silver pack in this video, but let's get into it. So we've got the premium gold players pack first up. I think this was the group award for the entirety of marquee matchups. From this one, we get boards. We get Emiliano Martinez. Looks a decent Premier League starter player. And 2 informs. We get Lapadula. Wasn't he the Summer Stars guy that literally everyone got? And I'm not even going to try and say that guy's name. I've got to quick sell both of them. List up Martinez. So yeah, that is very cool. So straight away, just from quick selling, we've made 20k. So can't complain about getting 2 informs. The reason I'm not selling them, trying to sell them for more, is just because unless I get one of the big boy informs, and this team of the week, do I think it's that good? No. Anyway, jumbo rare gold players pack. This one is untradeable. We get boards, which was guaranteed. We get the bare minimum. From the pack, which is 83 rated Raul Jimenez, as there is a guaranteed 83 plus in those packs. This is untradeable. We get Ruben Neves, Tap Sober, beep boop. Yeah, I guess it's an alright pack. We'll move on to the next one. There was more stuff. Anyway, we get a duplicate Martinez, who we will list up later. You may be wondering why you are 97 items on your transfers. That's way too many. I've been doing a stack load of bronze pack method, lads. And it really does work. Buy the pack for 750 and you sell the contents for like 900. Anyway, next one, we don't get boards. We get Rafinha, though, who I think sells for quite a bit. The Leeds man, he's in insane form recently, I think. And Paolo Ottavio, who is in quite a lot of SBC solutions. So if we get anything sick, we're going to have to just leave him now, because we're full on the transfer list. Anyway, we'll move on to the next pack. Rafinha must sell for a bit. Like, he looks really good. Like, 91 pace, I think. He might be 5-star. I'm not sure, though. Anyway, 3 more packs. Mixed players pack, they show up as whatever the rare is, so might show up as a bronze. It does not. It shows up as a gold. No boards. We get Aouar. Nice. Aouar's a really good starter player. And looks quite good again this year. Very well-rounded stats. So yeah, another half-decent pack. Nothing big yet. No walkouts. But hopefully you get one soon. It's the main part of it. Alright, 2 more packs then. Small, rare, mixed, and a prime electrum. We'll do the small, rare, mixed players pack. I'm excited for the ones to watch pack, but I'll have to do that later when it says I can actually open it. From this one, we do get Benny Boy Chilwell. Might be a duplicate, which is a problem, as obviously we do have a full transfer list at the minute. It is not a duplicate. So we've got 1 more pack. Hopefully we can get something good from that. These rewards haven't been too good, but obviously we made 20k off the first pack with those two informs, so to make 20k from it, and I didn't spend much on marquee matchups at all, obviously quite good. Last one then, we don't get boards, we get Vasslick. So in terms of that pack opening, not too good. I'll be back in a while with maybe some gameplay, or if not, we get Edward. Can't complain about odds on Edward. Absolute hero for me. Last year on Ultimate Team. But we'll move on to either some gameplay. I might not record it or not, I don't know. Or the One Swatch pack, which I'm obviously hyped for. Team One, there's Ronaldo, there's some other players, I don't know. We'll get to that. Alright, we're going to finish off the video here with the sales of pretty much the entire team. The Patos, that I saw some trading video, I don't know, and the bronze cards were from Bronze Pack Method. But to finish it off, I am very aware that I didn't play with Trent. But we're going to go out and buy Wan-Bissaka, who I probably won't play with either. But yeah, we're going to go out and buy Aaron Wan-Bissaka at 22.5k. And yeah, that's going to finish off the second of four videos of the day. Peace, I'll see you next time. Adios, amigos.